Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 22nd of our GoLang course. Continuing from the last lesson, in this lesson we will cover assessing byte data of a string, trying to update byte data of a string, converting byte rune to a string and vice versa, and slicing a string. So let's begin. First, I'm just going to create a variable called name and assign it a value of code and string. So here we have it, a name variable that's of type string, and a value of code and string. As I told you in the lesson, strings in Go are stored as sequence of bytes in memory. You can access each byte of the string using the index notation as with array or slice. So here, first letter is of type byte and it stores the byte data stored in the string at index 0. If you try to print it with fmt println, we should see the byte data printed to the console. So I can run our program using go run main.go and you can see 67 being printed. So while printing, Go has converted the byte data into a decimal number. And if you look up, you will see the ASCII code or the decimal representation of the byte data for C is 67. Let's now try to get the last letter of the string. I can use the len function, which should give us the number of bytes in the string. And remember, the last index of any sequence is length of the sequence minus 1. That's because every sequence in Go, like arrays, slices, start from a 0 index. So again, I am going to do fmt println last letter and then run our program to see the output. You can see 103 printed. This should be the ASCII notation for the letter lowercase g. Similar to slices and arrays, if we try to assess something that's out of range, we will get an out of range error. So if I try to do fmt println name and index that's greater than the last index, which is length name, we should see that Go throws a panic. So go run main.go, you can see we get a panic runtime error, index out of range. We are trying to assess index 13 with length 13, when the last index should be length minus 1, that is 13 minus 1, 12. So that is how you can access each byte data of a string. Now I'm just going to comment this out so that we can move on to the next section. As I told you in the previous lesson, strings are immutable in Go. That is, you can access data, but you cannot write or you cannot modify the byte data of a string. So if I try to do name, try to update the index value at 0 to A, you will see is straight away throwing an error. Cannot assign a value, unassigned operand. That's because we cannot modify the value of a string once it's created. You can, however, update the name variable or the name string variable to something new like this, but you cannot modify an existing string. So it's important to remember that you can update the variable string, but not the string directly or the byte data of the string directly. Moving on to the next section, which is converting byte or rune to a string. So in this lesson, we saw earlier that if I want to get access to the first character in the string, I can do first letter name index 0 and first letter will be byte. If we want to convert byte to a string, it is really simple. All you need to do is typecast it with a string, because rune bytes and strings are compatible and they can be converted to one and another. So I can do fmt println string and inside the braces first letter. So now if I run the program go run main.go, we should see C printed to the console, and that's what we get here. Now I can also create a rune var b of type rune has a value x, and if I want to convert it and print it as a string, I can do that as well, similar to what we did with the byte data. So I can do string inside string typecast the rune b into a string and then print the value. Go run main.go and you can see x printed. So that's basically how you convert rune or byte into a string. If you noticed, I've used single quotes for rune. Single quotes in Go can be used both for bytes and rune, while backticks and double quotes are only used for strings. So if I do byte, it should be fine as well. Again, running our program, we see the same outputs. So that's basically how you convert bytes and rune to a string. I'm just going to comment this out. And next, let's see how you convert a string into a byte or a rune. By now, you should know that string in Go is a sequence of bytes. So, when converting from a string to a rune or a byte type, we need to store the string as a slice of byte or rune. So, if I want to do rune name, what I need to do is rune and then braces and then name. So, you see, that's how we convert string to a rune slice. And if I printed fmt println rune name, we should see the rune slice values printed. And you can see it has converted the string into a rune. Similarly, I can do byte name and change the rune type to byte and byte name. Now, if I run the program, we should see a similar output. So that's basically how you convert a byte to a string and then a string to a byte or a rune slice. I will comment this out again. Next, let us look at slicing a string. Slicing a string is similar to how we slice the array or a slice. Suppose if I just want to print code in the string, I can do first name and slice name. We want from the start, so I'm just going to make the starting index and then 4 because we want third index to be printed. So 0, 1, 2, 3. And now if we print the string, you can see first name is string as well. Let's clear the console and run go run main.go, and there you have it. We have code printed to the console. And same as slicing, what if I remove the last index as well? Then we should have the complete copy of the string printed to the console. Code and string. Nice. I can do something else. I can specify a range 4 to 6 and then run a program. And you see it printed a space and the ampersand sign. So that is how you can use slicing to get a range of byte data from the string. If you remember from our previous lesson, I told you all this is working because every character in this string is of single byte. But as Go supports Unicode with UTF-8 encoding, any character can be from range 1 to 4 bytes. So if I change the string to include Unicode characters and then we try to do first character name index 0. So you should see we have the byte data. Now what we did last was we converted it before printing to a string. So I can do fmt println string and then provide first character. So that should work, right? Let's see if that works. Here we see that it printed something that doesn't match the first character. That's because, as I told you earlier, Unicode characters can have more than 1 byte. Since we are only getting first byte from the character where the character size is more than 1 byte, what we see is corrupted data. So you should be careful when working with Unicode string. Now a way to get over it is first converting the string to a rune slice and then accessing each character. So what I can do is I can say Unicode string is a rune slice which has name. This way we are converting each character in the string into a rune so that when we go ahead and convert it back to a string, we should see the correct output. So this time I'm doing first character Unicode string. I want the first rune from a rune slice. That means it will automatically pick up the right number of bytes for it. So if we run our program, you should see we are getting the correct string printed or the correct character printed to the console. So again, you should be careful when the string has Unicode characters because each Unicode character may not always map to a single byte. Earlier, everything was working because our string was code and learn, in which every character had 1 byte of data, which is not the case here. So this is one way of dealing with Unicode characters in the string. You can also use strings and UTF-8 packages provided by the Go language. We will look at packages when we cover packages in a future lesson. But for now, you can use this. Again, as you see here, rune is an alias for int32 which can store 1 to 4 bytes, which perfectly makes sense since Unicode characters can take 1 to 4 bytes. So in this lesson, first we covered accessing each byte of a string using indices, followed by converting byte or rune data into a string, and the other way around, that is string to byte slice or a rune slice. Then we looked at slicing a string, and in the end, we looked at how to handle Unicode characters in a string. The slicing that we did with string we'll work with the Unicode string or the rune slice, because obviously it's a slice. So I can do, I want first character to second character. Let's run our program and see what output we get. So you see first two characters printed. I hope you enjoyed the lesson and it helped you understand how strings work in Go and how to be careful when there are Unicode characters. As we go along the lessons, we will cover more and more insights into how to work with strings. But for now, they should help us build a strong base. Please feel free to comment under the video if you have any questions or reach out to the Discord server. I will see you in the next lesson where we will cover maps. Happy coding.